Okay. Wow, wow, wow. Hello, everyone. We're going to start. First of all, thank you guys for coming. And unfortunately, like, we haven't been able to celebrate our accomplishments in person, but that definitely doesn't degrade the memories we've made online and the achievements we had as a club. So this past term was filled with many memories and new events. But despite the setbacks, our board, as well as all you members, have done your absolute best to devote your time and effort to make sure that this term was the best it could possibly be. So from summer families to member induction to now, all the accomplishments we've had so far would not have been possible without the help of all of you right here. Wow, I'm looking at Koi and you look so creepy. So although we'll be looking back at our accomplishments, it's important to remember the most important role in our club is our general members. So without all of you, our board would have no one to serve. And you guys are what kept us going throughout this whole year. We were only able to reach the hours we've had and the communities we serve through the countless hours members like you put in and dedicate to this club. Everyone here has played a role to make CSULB Circle K as unique as it is. And so tonight's banquet is not just about the new and old board, it's about our club as a whole and the accomplishments that we were able to reach. So I hope you guys are all excited to get this started, and I'll officially call this banquet to order at 7:12 p.m. Wow. Okay, I will now pass it on to Lillian to give us a year in review.
Hello, everyone. I am Lillian, your secretary from the 2020-21 term, and I'll be quickly highlighting what we were able to accomplish together as CSULB CKI, along with our totals for the year. So, alrighty. Although the majority of like our past year was like being online and such, like that didn't stop our club, obviously. From the past, like last summer, we had our first ever summer families, which was like, it was a great experience for a lot of members. You're able to grow closer with one another, not only with between our individual families, but with other families as well before our school year started. And further on, we were also able to establish our famous club Discord, where a lot of our members have our late night talks. We play games there. We also host many of our socials there. With almost all of our events online here for this term, we had a lot of online service events, and then like our member, like some events that our members enjoyed were Seven Cups Therapy, UNICEF's Math for Good, our monthly service marathons, and much more, actually. So those are some events that we had this term. We also not only continue to exemplify Circle K's three tenets, service, leadership, and fellowship, but we also grew closer as a club with the online setting. So for this year's totals, we surpassed our service goal, achieving 2,121 service hours for leadership, 5,340 hours, and for fellowship, 4,529 fellowship hours. Yeah, as you can see, it's amazing to see how far we have come, regardless of like online limitations that we are faced with. And we were able to bring home like several multiple awards from DCON back in March. And CSULB Circle K would definitely not be able to like where we are today without all the efforts of everyone, all of you, our general members, family heads, committee and impact teams, board officers, district leads, and our Kiwanis. So again, we thank you for all your dedication and commitments throughout this term. Like, our club wouldn't be like such an amazing club without you all. So thank you. I will now pass it on to Mariella to talk about next.
Hello, hello. So our fundraising chair, Melania, couldn't be here, but these are her words, so take them into consideration. So anyways, as another year ends, hopefully everyone made it out okay through these challenging times. I would like to summarize the fundraising totals that we raised together for the term. For the pediatric trauma program, we raised $346. For the environmental defense fund, we raised $497. Kiwanis Family House, we raised $359. And finally, for the NAACP, we raised $662. We would like to really thank all of the general members, the alumni, and everyone else who contributed to the four DFIs. I could assure you all that the proceeds will be used to help make meaningful impacts from projects that range from environmental restorations to supporting the largest civil rights organizations. I'm happy and proud to have been able to see the club thrive and shine despite the sudden transition. And I can't wait to see what the future fundraising events come to follow with the new term ahead. And next, I would like to invite Kyla to take over.
Hi everyone, I'm Kyla, your immediate past public relations chair. I know it's been quite rough with this whole pandemic, and staying active has never been more difficult when we all just see each other through a screen. But through your perseverance and dedication to this club, we want to recognize all of you who have put in your precious time and effort to chair an event and develop your leadership skills while doing so. For that, you have made this club better by helping out in our events and engaging with our members, not to mention filling out that surf at the end, wink. And so we thank you again with all our hearts and hope that you and many others more continue to help chair our events, which keep our club running. Now I'd like to pass it on to Lillian and Guy to present the next
award. Oh my God. I forgot to change the slide. Anyways. Wow, here are adventures. Wow.
Hello, everyone. My name is Guy, and I'm the Past Membership Development and Recognition Chair. I'm here to talk about MRP with the help of Past Secretary Lillian. The Member Recognition Program, or MRP, is the largest district-wide recognition initiative implemented to create a goal-setting mindset for all members of Circle K to work towards. In addition to the service hours requirements, members are tasked with other tags that must be met in order to receive the recognition title, such as attending various Kiwanis and inter-club events or hosting a webinar.
The following recipients have been attending service and CKI events regardless of the online limitations. And before we start, I would like to applaud every one of you because it's truly been a challenge. It really shows that your consistent hard work towards CKI's three tenants. And these members were recognized at this year's DCON, but today we will recognize them at our banquet right now.
For bronze, these individuals contributed 40 service hours or more to the community, along with at least four additional tags. The following individuals are
Pushan Chu,
Taylor Gerard,
Jonathan Chino,
Jonathan Kim,
Pearl Netrayana,
Anthony Fan,
Guy Song Cao,
and Alan Vu.
Well, you'll be moving next to silver. So for silver, these individuals contributed 65 service hours or more to the community, along with at least six additional tags. The following individuals are Olivia Chang, Cesar Cornejo, Diane Nguyen, Lillian Ahn, and Tommy Thatch.
For gold, these individuals contributed 105 service hours or more to the community, along with at least eight additional tags. The following individuals are Kyla Anderson and Ricardo Porras.
Moving on to platinum, for platinum, these individuals contributed 160 service hours or more to the community, along with at least 10 additional tags. The following individuals are Audrey Halim, Lenore Fabi, and McKenna Pullen. Wow, wow, wow.
So final congrats to everyone that received MRP. Hope you guys had a fun year doing service and achieving all your tags this year, despite all of the different circumstances that we had. So now we will be moving on to family awards.
Hello, hello. I'm Jonathan Nicina. I was this past year's MD and E. For the family awards, this past year, among your six families, we had a family competition. And we're going to award the family year runner-up and the family the family of the year as well. We'll start with the family of the year runner-up.
So I will be presenting Family of the Year runner-up. So for this year, this runner-up for this year's family system started off slow and ended things with a bang this spring semester. I had a chance to attend their very first social, and I was immediately welcomed by the warm members that were present. Their family head is also someone exceptional. They might be a hardcore gamer, but they're also hardcore in dedicating their care and love to the family they created. They continue to do a great job this semester, catching up with the family during these hectic times and reconnected with everyone. From their third place win in fall, they have now become the second place winner for this year's Family Awards. Give it up for the family that's burning with passion and cool to the touch, Freeze Flame.
Wow, wow.
Okay, I'll help you, Olive. Wow, wow, wow. Wow.
I'm not even part of Freeze Flame. Where's Freeze Flame?
Wow, 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 that's my family.
We can talk.
Where's the collaborative sheesh from Freeze Flame?
Sheesh!
All right, congrats, Freeze Flame. All right, next, we're going to award the Family of the Year. To this family of the year, congrats, you did it. Your family won the competition. Your family is on top. Thanks to the fantastic leadership from their family head and the combined efforts with their family as well, this family is able to work through all of this past year's challenges. Through the use of their unique family's personality, and all of their very interesting socials, this family continued and constantly proved that they had an abundance of spirit. This family, I remember whenever I would go to their socials, they always seemed to have the same mindset when it came to bullying me. And this team very much so worked together on that. Whether they were playing poker or seeing who could drop blocks faster, this team would always find very unique ways to spend time together and enjoy each other's company. This family is from outer space. From day one, they were a category typhoon. From the tumultuous socials to the crazy nights in space, this family has finally done it. Congratulations, Zephyr Nova.
Wow, 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 wow.
Let's go, Caesar.
Oh, yo.
Cheese.
All right. Caesar, give us your speech.
No, I have speech. Do I really have to give a speech?
Oh, wait, I didn't change the slide. Wow, wow, wow.
Thanks. Thank you very much, Mr. Swank Cow and Mr. Chino.
That's Mr. Potter.
Mr. Potter,
thank you for saying
Mr. the correct Dirty
name.
Homeless Potter.
Oh my gosh. All right. Moving on, we also wanted to recognize an individual family head. The core of this family system are the six family heads who run and maintain them. The family head of the year represents someone who did an outstanding job in creating different social interaction opportunities for their family to engage in while uplifting each other or each individual member in their family to excel and enjoy their journey here in our club.
This year, the title is being presented to a family head who matches these descriptions to the T and so much more. This meeting they led this year is one who loves them with all their effervescent heart. Not only did this head dedicate their time to loving their family, but the head of other families as well. They are the backbone and support system for everyone involved in this process and never fails to find a way to motivate everyone to be the best version of themselves. On behalf of Jonathan, myself, and the family heads, we want to thank them for their burning desire to truly make Circle K a home for everyone and for their efforts this entire year. The family head of the year goes to my dear friend and outstanding family head, Sophia Villarreal of Bubble Blast.
Wow, Sophia.
Whoa.
We got surprise guest T-Pain to present this award to Sophia.
Thank you.
Is she crying?
Good job, Sophia. All right, so now please welcome past VPS Audrey and Service Chair McKenna for their service remarks.
In honor of Olivia. Wow. What's poppin', boomers and zoomers? Our term was riddled with Zoom burnout, limited in-person meetings, then none at all, to limited opportunities. Despite all the trouble, I knew that our club embodied the spirit of service. We define service as the act of helping another human being in need. Our altruistic mentality led us to donate over 1,200,783. That was a lot of grains of rice.
Oh my lord.
On free rise. Yes. Anyways, we wrote countless numbers of cards to the elderly, veterans, and frontline medical workers. We presented an entire environment lecture to Key Club Division 13 South. We prepared food bags for our low income seniors, transcribed academic and literary works for the Smithsonian, and prison letters with Between the Bars transcription, provided free captions for different, often educational videos with Amara, became trained listeners on Seven Cups, promoted advocacy for BLM and sexual assault with emailing and creating resources, created literacy cards for low income seniors, held 12 our service marathons and so on. And all those like started to become known in the district. Our list goes on. While this year looked hella different, we could never stop forgetting about who matters most, especially in these vulnerable times, our community. And for that, I'm always proud of this club and for everything we've done in one short year. And McKenna.
Mm-hmm. But even with all the beautiful faces we saw at our multitude of service events this past term, there's one individual who truly stood out. They were an individual inspired by their peers and in turn became someone to inspire the next generation and all of us as well, to be active, involved, and dedicated to this amazing club we call ours. They truly stood out in this important tenet of service, making MRP requirements look like child's play. To them, every service event is a unique opportunity to do something good for their community. They always love to see the impact they could have, all while finding new ways to bond with everyone who would attend with them. You could literally find them at every event, to the point if they weren't there, you were scared something happened to them. They did every event from online to in-person and participated in every way they could, from chairing, attending, all the way to guaranteeing a picture was taken at the very end. Also, a small disclaimer, when I say in person, that's when it was allowed. Yes, thank you, don't sue me. Anyway, they are a star that truly shined, and one of the rarest diamonds found in even the deepest of cocoa caverns. Thus, it is my pleasure to award the Service Recognition Award to our very own Leonard Fabii.
Oh my God, it's my twin.
That's my successor.
I'm related to her.
Beach.
Oh, shoot. Thank you.
Oh. Wait, what is that?
Is that Lenore's family in the background? Or are you with your friends? Sounds like they're getting further away.
It sounded like a
like
stadium.
Those fake audience like woo.
Yeah.
They're very real, I promise.
Lenore brought a studio audience with her.
Would you like to say anything, Lenore?
Thank you, guys. I wouldn't have gone if it wasn't for the people that inspired me to tee-hee.
Wow. Amazing words from our next VPA. And now with that, we wrap up service and throw it back to our favorite treasurer of the past term and favoritist PR chair of the past term as well, Mariella and Kyla.
Hello again, Kyla here with the immediate past treasurer, the lovely Mariella Michelle.
Hello, hello again, everyone. It is I again. So Circle K International is an organization run primarily by student leaders, people who have taken it upon themselves to go above and beyond in their involvement to aid in the running of the club. Family heads, workshop hosts, committee members, event chairs, you guys name it. We appreciate the dedication and hard work every one of you put into keeping our home club thriving, especially in these tough times. So tonight, Kyla and I are here to recognize someone who has demonstrated to us and everyone here what it really means to be a leader.
This person's involvement in our club is at another level. They're actively part of not one, but two committees or teams, such as Spirit Committee and our Mental Wellness Impact Team. They were able to lead icebreakers during our general meetings, chair mental wellness impact team events, such as conversation corners, attend so many of our club events. I see this person literally everywhere, and her activeness in the club is not one to go unnoticed. It also warms my heart to know that they are in my Zova family. Yeah, and even won Family Star of the Month in February.
So it is our pleasure to present the Leadership Recognition Award to none other than Taylor Gerard.
Now to the tenant.
Alan?
Mr. Vu?
Yes. All righty. Since this is supposed to be Hannah's part, but she is not here, I will be voice acting as Hannah. So give me 1 second as to find my Hannah picture. All right. Oh. Ah. Is it working?
No.
Yeah. All right. Damn, I'm gone. But anyways, I'm gonna read this in Hannah's voice. Hey, hey, so for this next award, we'll be recognizing a member who has really stood out to us. And as they are, they're also... Oh.
I can't tell if it's his actual internet.
I thought I was frozen.
Okay.
That's Ren's, not Hannah.
Yeah, you're wrong person on board.
All right, is it good now?
Is it? Should I say it?
Oh. He has too much drip, clearly.
Olivia, do you want me to say it?
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, everybody, for joining me on this.
He's back, Alan's y'all.
Back. All right. I'm back. So, as Hannah said, so for this next award, we'll be recognizing a member who has really stood out to us and consistently created an environment that fully embodied what fellowship is. As crazy and blunt as they are, they're also equally as supportive, funny, and a life to the party. All right, so make no mistake, this individual can be seen at family socials, general meetings, and even Discord. This individual strives to get along with everybody by including them into the conversation and telling riveting tales from their past. Whether it be getting golf clubs from a celebrity to running into their ex at Chick-fil-A, their personality isn't the only thing that raises the roof, mainly because their 5'2 height does it for them. Their sense of humor transcends their cravings for Arby's and longing for their divorced wife. Although their Sokka ex Zuko fanfic virtual background raises some concerns, it is without a doubt this individual, named after a Las Vegas hotel, salad, and Mexican civil rights activist, truly embodies the fellowship tenant. So with a big round of applause, please congratulate Cesar Cornejo.
Yay, Papa Porn.
It's Cornejo.
I hate that. I really hate that you encountered my life story.
Is it working?
It's from all the years of knowing you.
Unfortunate number of years.
Ricardo, is my applause working?
Yes.
It's very bad applause.
No. It's
no,
perfect.
No. It's good. It's good.
Yeah.
Wow, Ellen, do you want to pass it on?
He muted himself.
All right. I would like to pass it on to the one and only Renslane.
Awesome. Thank you, Alan. Hi, everybody. This is Renslane, your outgoing technology chair. And for this next award, I would love to present the new member of the year award to an out of this world individual who went beyond the role of a general member within their first year of Circle K. Last fall, this person became a general member who quickly became a recognizable face at service events, general meetings, and socials. Not only did they consistently attend events, but they took the initiative to chair service events like Operation Gratitude and UNICEF War Puzzles for Good. When this Bobo barista wasn't at events, they were cooking up something special through committees. Yes, plural. They embraced the work that they took on and the opportunities provided by these committees this term and brought a lot of smiles to the people around them on Discord. This person is seemingly as quiet as they are incredible, but their dedication to Circle K speaks volumes to their character, especially when experiencing their first year of our club virtually. And without further ado, I would love to present this new member of the year award to Diana Nguyen.
Wow. I would like a large Thai tea, please.
Oh, no.
Let's go.
Oh, yeah, give us your best sheesh.
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 All right,
we're all going to her boba shop later to congratulate her.
To give her the award.
Oh, she's not here.
Boba.
Yes, drop in by press tea, you know. But congrats to Diane. I'm proud of all the amazing things that she's done in TKI so far, and I'm excited to see where this new chapter of VPS takes her. And we'll go ahead and transition to Jonathan Ichino for the returning member of the year award.
Hello, everyone. It's Jonathan again. It is time for the returning member of the year award. Returning members are the very fabric of our club. Whether they take up leadership positions or simply participate in club events, they are constantly making contributions to our club's livelihood. Returning members craft every new member's experience after having had their own crafted when they joined this club. It is truly thanks to all of our returning members that we are able to continue serving the community as well as our Circle K family. The recipient of this award is one that goes above and beyond what anyone would expect from a returning member. While they have made many contributions to our club, they also show incredible care and consideration for all of our members. This member constantly reaches out to other members and refuses to let others feel isolated or unheard. They are always willing to lend an ear or support people when they need some confidence. This member has a seemingly constant presence within our club and is always open to study, play games, or watch something on our Discord. As a leader, this person is diligent, open-minded, and creative. They are always suggesting events that are easily accessible and appealing to all. They are also often the first to help out whenever anyone asks. This individual has an abundance of love for Circle K that shines even to the people outside of our club. When coupled with their amazing humor, this person is one of the most welcoming and friendly people in our club. Although this past year was only their second at Long Beach, it feels as if they have always been here. Please join me in congratulating Jonathan Kim.
Sheesh.
My favorite Jonathan. Let's go.
The best Jonathan.
There's only one Jonathan. I'm Harry Potter.
The past three people weren't here.
Congrats, Jacob. When you see this on YouTube. Oh, is Jacob here? He's not right.
We're... No.
Next, we have the committee awards. So please welcome
Ricardo,
who's presenting them.
I thought he was just going to welcome everyone. All right, guys. So for this first award, it's actually for the outstanding committee member for Spirit Committee. Hannah's busy making coffee right now, so I will be presenting the award in her place. So take in mind, this is her speech, not mine. Hi again. For this next award, I had a pretty difficult time sobbing over having to only choose one person for this award. Spirit Committee has worked tremendously hard since day one and pulled through with all the obstacles that came their way. I am beyond proud of each of you for the work and dedication you put into this committee. That was the first for all of us, so thank you. However, there does have to be an award given. I feel this person truly picked up and filled in for all that I lacked. And even when a member of the committee was no longer active, they made up for that position as well. She is the not so little that always keeps me in check. You will always be seeing a lot more of her in this upcoming term as she takes my place. And to ad lib a little bit, I am very proud of my very own daughter and mentee, Adora Mae Bassano.
She's not the sheesh, not anything but the sheesh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah.
Oh no. Oh god.
Thank now you. I'm passing the phone off to someone who's quite literally built different. Anthony Fan.
I'm built different. Hold on. So it's your boy Anthony, and I'm coming in with the Outstanding Media Award. I would like to present this Outstanding Committee Award to a very special someone. They have done an amazing job at fulfilling their position and their duty, and also keeping a super positive attitude. From being someone who is irreplaced to me as a committee member and also as a member in the fam in CSULB CKI, they have supported me as a historian by attending numerous events and contributing numerous ideas during meetings. Okay, that was my part, okay? And I was AJ, my littlest part, but he wasn't here because he got his second dose of the vaccine, so he's feeling out of it, so I'm a cover for him. As a fresh joined last term, I didn't know a lot of folks in the club, but this person always showed up and out to pretty much all of the club's meetings and the events I attended and chaired. They were definitely a good face of welcome, considering they were also my mentor-mentee fam line. I'll give away. And it was also a pleasure working with them. And on the count of 1, 2, 3, congratulations to Lenore for me.
Thank you. What is that?
Yeah.
Hey, Lenore. Okay. With no necessary introduction needed, we got the famous Mr. Renslings to present the Outstanding Committee Award for Tech.
Awesome, thanks, Anthony. Wait, hi, everybody. Back again to present another special award to another special individual. They have done an above and beyond job with their position this term, and this person has also made many positive contributions to the meeting discussions, the website design, and also the web content. They, you know, aside from being a star, they also designed a stellar layout for the website's primary recognition pages. And honestly, I couldn't have imagined the website being as unworldly as it has been without their creativity, dedication, and support on our web pages and beyond. Not to mention, this person also gives the committee helpful tips on being better plant parents after a committee meeting sometimes. I always appreciate this person for everything that they've done this year and for being a part of the club's first ever technology committee. They did an amazing job planting the seeds for a better website next term and will continue to inspire future web designs with their work. And that said, the Outstanding Tech Committee Member Award goes to Kari Nguyen. Congrats, Kari. I'm excited to see where life takes you after graduation. And that said, we'll go ahead and transition to Emily Aquino for the next Outstanding Committee Member Award.
Okay, hello. As many of you know, I've had the pleasure of working with four amazing and hardworking mental wellness impact team members. All the members went above and beyond in their efforts for mental health advocacy and developing what is now known as the Mental Wellness Resource Database. All the work we did was completely voluntary. So really stepping up to the plate to just even be an impact team member really showed us how much mental health meant to each of them. But for tonight, the team heads, me and Tommy, wanted to spotlight and honor a specific member in particular. They really made an impact on us, seeing how much they were balancing in their school life, personal life, and other extracurricular and CKI responsibilities. Not to mention their very first experience of their very first year of college is set in this stressful and very confusing virtual pandemic era of our lives. It's really fulfilling and amazing to see how much they've grown within the term. I really love how excited and passionate they are about being able to lead and facilitate the conversation corners. This member definitely reminded me a lot of what it was like to be a very enthusiastic and excited first year. It's definitely inspiring to see how involved they are and how active they strive to be. I really can't wait to see what other amazing things this member will do in the future. Without further ado, the Outstanding Committee Member Award goes to Taylor, but I don't think she's here. But congrats anyways.
Yeah. And before we move on, we should give a big like shout out to Emlu and Tommy for leading the mental wellness impact team throughout this past year as general members, with no like, you know, they like no one told them to do anything. They wanted to do this themselves as like a passion project, and you guys really did a lot this past year. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Emlu. Thank you, Tommy.
Go, Emlu.
Thank you, Tommy. Thank you, Emlu.
Love you, Tommy.
Okay. All right. So next, we're going to be going on to the executive board's choice. What is executive board's choice? Well, the executive board chooses. Yes. All right. So thank you all for coming out to CSULB Banquet. As we all know, appointed board is the backbone of this very club. And without all 11 members on this board, there would be no Circle K at Cal State Long Beach. They gave their all in working towards improving club foundations, enriching member experiences, and most importantly, rebelled against Olivia. And for that, I wish to award all of them with the highest honor possible. However, one officer did stand up amongst the rest by showing how passionate they are about this club by even going to extreme measures as sacrificing time for school or even social life to give their all into every aspect of their position. I have seen this person grow from humble beginnings and saw that from the very moment they joined this club, they were destined to be a leader. It was so apparent that they even signed up for the club a year before joining officially. Whether it came down to educating members about what our organization is, planning out all the recruitment strategies with additional supplements, or revamping all of our social media platforms and adding a new one, does the renegade? This person constantly reminds me why I became an officer in the first place. I know that with this being my final event, I will miss this person constantly messaging me in the middle of the night for questions and then responding 3 to 5 business days after I give them an answer about random Circle K stuff. And I hope she continues to thrive in not only her Circle K career, but in the rest of what life has to offer her. She may call me father, but today I'm calling her our A board officer of the term. You may all know who this is at this point, and I expect either her or someone very close to her to be teary-eyed after this speech. So it is with my greatest pleasure to award the eBoard's Choice Award to our very own public relations chair, Kyla Anderson.
Wow.
Wow. Let's go, Kyla.
Yo.
Yo. Wow.
Let's go, our Kyla.
And now I would like to pass it on to Koi with A-Board's Choice.
All right. Hello, everyone. I'm Koi. And this is Appointed Board's Choice. What is Appointed Board Choice? Well, the Appointed Board chooses. So elected board making up 5 people is very hard to choose from all of them. They've done a great job within the term, and we're all proud of all of them. But for this award goes to someone who I've been close to for essentially my entire time in this club. And without a doubt, they've been an inspiration to me and many others in the club. Sorry for the tease. It was a pleasure to be on board with them and have even voted for them to be elected for our term. In our term, this person has been a very crucial and important part of eBoard and is one of the reasons why they were able to lead all of us through the term successfully. They have constantly gone out of their way to go beyond their duties, help their fellow officers, and became the friendly face of the club that we all know and love. They have personally helped me with tasks on board and organizing some of our biggest events this past year, which was really exciting. When I asked the other A board members, I heard almost the exact same thing from them. This person has helped everyone in A board, and we all had their guidance at one point or another. Now, I think I've talked enough about how happy we are to have had them run this club this year. Let's congratulate our appointed board choice, Olivia Chang, my mentor.
Do the roar.
Olivia,
do the roar.
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 Hey, she did the roar.
That's my present.
Oh, stop hiding.
Congratulations, Olivia, my mentor.
Thank you.
I move this on to Alan Vu.
Alrighty, alrighty. So we have the Clive Graham Hall of Fame. So named after Long Beach Kiwanian Clive Graham, who during his 36 years as a Kiwanian received almost every award the club had to offer, the Clive Graham Hall of Fame aims to recognize a member who has made monumental impacts throughout their Circle K career. This award goes to a member who through dedication, commitment, and service have exemplified the tenets, principles, and motto of this organization and have made significant contributions to Circle K. This individual always goes above and beyond in their responsibilities and is a natural role model for those around them. So please join me in giving a giant, humongous out of this world size round of applause for... Next line.
Olivia Tang, woo! Yeah. Let's go, Olivia.
Let's go.
Wow, Olivia.
So cheese.
Got the double county movie. Let's go.
Yay.
Olivia's already.
Yeah, that's our president.
Olivia's already giving out the waterworks. She's not ready for the speeches.
I'm not.
All righty. With that, I'm passing it off to Guy.
Hello again, everyone. So I'll be talking a little bit about past term recognition. So my goal this year as a chair was to revamp and revitalize the definition of recognition within the club. This meant conveying the message that everyone deserves recognition no matter what type of gear you played in this clock we call Circle K. To my golden cadets, congrats on making such an impact in the club in the short amount of time you have been on this space journey. The cadet title this year was chosen to emphasize the willingness to explore and learn, a challenge that you were all up for this year. To my golden veterans, on behalf of the board and I, we would like to thank you for your unwavering commitment to our club and standing right beside us as we strive to develop our club during these uncertain times. Your experience and efforts are valuable to us and did not go unnoticed. Just like your titles, I hope you all continue to stay golden and keep that shine that I saw in each and every single one of you. You can display the names.
Oh my God. Sorry. Wow.
So congrats to everyone who received a golden title this on this term, and all your names on the screen. Congratulations. Yay!
That's a lot of super time.
Everyone stay golden. Please welcome back President Olivia to recognize those who took initiatives beyond the club level.
Okay. Hello, everyone. I hope you guys have been enjoying all the awards so far. As we've recognized all the hard work that our members have done on the club level, there have also been some hidden stars that have worked tirelessly behind the scenes this past year. Last year, I mentioned that at the root of Circle K International is the clubs and our general members. However, we wouldn't be international without those who serve our organization outside of our home club, representing CSULB through their strong leadership. These few individuals have gone above and beyond the club level this past year, allowing CSULB to get out of our bubble and become a presence known throughout the division, district, and international. So serving on the Metro Divisional Leadership Team this past year, we had Nathan Cortez, Sophia Villavial, Ricardo Flores, Zhao, San Augustine, I'm gonna F up everyone's name again, Renz Lane. On the district level, we had Guy Swankow on the District Membership Recognition Committee, McKenna Pollan on the Technology Committee, and serving on the CNH District Board, we had Matthew Kim as our District Tech Chair. And then finally, but not least, on the international level, we had Tommy Thatch as our International Trustee, which is the highest position in Circle K. Not the highest position. Highest position is international president, but the international board is the highest level of Circle K. So yeah, wow. I know a lot of you guys don't really get recognized as much on the club level, but yeah. I will now pass it on to Ricardo to present club superlatives.
Hello again. This was originally going to be me and Hannah, but you already know the drill. So for our superlatives, with all the heavy, crying, tear-jerking speeches we've been giving, we would like to take this moment to bring it back to a more lighthearted setting and recognize people for their individualistic personality traits and quirks that make them unique. Starting with the coveted Club Flirt Award. Ah, yes, of course.
we are getting to the very first superlative of the night, and no one deserves the title of club flirt more than our very own KFC chair, soft boy Alan Vu. By the way, he's single.
Daddy, daddy.
All right, Alan, give us one good sheesh. Give us one sheesh, Alan. Thank you. Moving on, we got our American Idol Award. Our next award is someone who sang their way out into our hearts, and he will always play those strings, but never our emotions. Give it up for our American Idol for Cal State Long Beach, Yazid McCoon. Right, Yazid, sing us a song right now.
Wait, why is it me? It should be Kyla, not me.
Sorry,
it was voted by the people.
Have spoken, Yazid.
I don't know. This is rigged.
The people have spoken. Next, we have most likely to be a Kiwanian. Wow. I think this one is really obvious because they always have been a very big friendo to all of us, even after CKI. Let us all give a round of applause for our new Kiwanian, Tommy Thatch. Everybody already knew before I said something.
Let's go, Tommy!
Maria, you could look forward to your next sign-up.
For our social media star, no one has had a bigger social media following than our very own TikTok dancer, gas blaster, and freestyle rapper, I can't even say it anymore because I was about to say Fartacanus. Macarenas. Not here to give out her TikTok following. Oh, Lenore came back. Wow, she left. Now we have the most poggers / most influential Twitch streamer. It's PogChamp time, and let's ring that notification bell because our very own future Kiwanian is collecting all the dubs tonight. Tommy Thatch is out here with the double award winning. Does anyone want to plug Tommy's Twitch channel? Caesar?
Twitch.tv/ Tommy Thatchett with a T.
Next, we have best friends. So originally, I didn't have a speech written out for this one because someone pulled a prank on us and put me and Olivia on there. But the real winners of this are someone who don't need introductions. We all know the dynamic duo within this club. I think it's very obvious which pair won this one. The Batman and Superman of this club, Kyla Anderson and Lenore Fabii.
Wow. Even though Lenore had other people in her background.
Y'all can figure out which one's Superman and which one's Batman. And then for our final superlative, we have most likely to fall asleep on Discord. We don't want to wake them up on our last award. They might be sleeping right now after they took care of all their children and got nominated to be the best family head of the year. Oh, I didn't mean to spoil it. My bad. But she's probably asleep right now, so she can't hear it. So let's congratulate Sophia Villarreal.
Wake up.
I would ask her to unmute because she's probably snoring right now. I'm sorry, what, Sophia? All I heard was...
I'm awake.
All right, that ends it for our superlatives. And I would like to hand it off to Jonathan and Olivia for senior recognition.
Wow. We're now at the final stop in the galaxy.
We would like to congratulate and recognize all the seniors this year for reaching the end of their voyage.
All the years we've dedicated to blood, sweat, and tears have finally reached an end. From all the all-nighters to final exams, be proud of all that we've accomplished.
As you're leaving this galaxy, do not be afraid of what lies next. Whether you already have plans or you haven't the foggiest idea, be confident. Be confident in the you that graduated and the you that put in the hard work that got you where you are. I hope you are filled with excitement as the next stage in your life is about to begin.
I didn't know we wrote so much. All the memories and friends we've made in this club will always be here to support you and cheer you on. Whether you are moving on to graduate school or will begin pursuing your career, we wish you the best of luck. Without further ado, please join me in recognizing our graduating seniors. Wow. Okay, are you ready, Jonathan? You're starting.
Jonathan Kim graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in Sociology, plans to work in social work and grad, and wants to go to grad school somewhere. His favorite CKI moment was when he walked in through the doors for his first general meeting. I see people greeting me and welcoming me and being nice to me. And then in that moment, I knew I was home at CSU Fullerton.
Okay. Next in Battle Rock, we have Kari Nguyen, graduating with a BA in design, and her plans are for the future are travel so much sushi. So she wants to travel and eat sushi, I think. And then her favorite CKI moment is the late night talks with about our feeling. Yeah. And I guess this one's Kari. Just kidding. Moving on.
From the family head of Bubble Blast, we have Sophia Villarreal, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Health Science, Community Health Education. Plans for the future? Grad school. Favorite CKI moment? Meeting all the crazy people I now call my friends. Thank you for your endless support.
Then moving on to Deep Dark, we have Luke Breda, graduating with a BA in Psychology, and plans for the future. Oh, I thought that said BI high schooler. Plans for the future, even though I made these slides. Plans for the future, be a high school teacher. Favorite CKI moment, meeting his girlfriend. So cute.
Also from Deep Dark, we have Ricardo Porras, graduating with a BA in Psychology. Plans for the future? Cry. favorite CKI moment? Bugging Olivia.
I'm mad. Wow. And then from Freeze Flame, we have Kathleen Panganibo. I've known her for like 5 years. I still don't know her last name. Graduating with a BS in biology, and her plans for the future are going to medical school and becoming a pediatrician. Favorite CKI moment, getting her mentees, Richard and Millennia, and FTC 2018 and FTC 2019, and being on my committee. Hey! I guess meeting her boyfriend there, but let's not mention that. Okay, next.
From Freeze Flame, we have Tommy Thatch, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Physical Education. His plans for the future are to get credentials for being a PE teacher and being certified in training. Favorite Circle K moment, also FTC, probably not Olivia's.
Rude.
I'm kidding, of course it was Olivia's.
Yeah, it is probably FTC 2018. Tommy would perform at the campfire skit and win first place.
True.
Wow. Next from Starshine, we have Anthony Wan, graduating with a BS in computer engineering, and plans for the future. Get a job, I guess. What a mood. Favorite CKI moment, Pally fan, best fan.
From Zephyr Nova, we have Kyla Anderson, graduating with a BS in molecular cell biology and physiology, and with a minor in chemistry. Plans for the future. I plan to become a healthcare professional, but still exploring and keeping my options open. Favorite CKI moment? I've had many, many favorite moments in this club, one of which was chicken nut bread. I was basically hanging out after a Zoom meeting or webinar with CKI friendos, and we ended up sharing Filipino jokes like this one. I laughed so hard, I almost peed my pants.
Emphasis on I almost peed my pants. What do you call an ugly cow? E-call? Thank you, Emblu. Okay, next. From Zephyr Nova, we have Cesar Cornejo, graduating with a BA in economics. Wow, wow, wow. Plans for the future, wasting away inside, aka getting a job. And favorite CKI moment is meeting all of the wonderful people. Wow, that's me. Wow, thank you, Cesar, from this club. Oh.
Also from Zephyr Nova, we have Olivia Chang, graduating with a Bachelor of Fine Arts in Graphic Design and a minor in Public Relations. Plans for the future. She wants to travel and hopefully work at a design agency in the entertainment industry, and also wants to open up a boba shop next to someone else's ramen shop. Favorite CKI moment. Fall Training Conference 2019 and all the leadership opportunities I've had and people I've met throughout my time in CKI. Wow, 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 wow.
Well, okay, next. Wow. Next, and I think, is this final? Yes. We have Betty from Zephyr Nova as well, graduating with a BS in Business Administration, Human Resource Management option, and plans for the future, travel a bit, then work for a Fortune 500 company. And favorite CKI moment is mentor reveal, spring 2020. Shout out to Caesar, I guess. Yeah. Wow, wow, wow. Oh, wait, is that? Yeah. Oh. Wow. These are all our graduating seniors. Unless you didn't feel
congratulations.
Wow, 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 wow. Congratulations. Oh, yeah. Oh, so. Yeah, congrats to all the graduating seniors. It was so nice hearing about your plans for the future and reminiscing back on some past CKI memories. My sister keeps calling me. What up? Anyways, thank you for joining us in honoring all the senior accomplishments throughout their CKI journey, and we'll now be passing it off to Anthony with an end of the year video.
I'm muted, okay. It's your boy, Anthony P, coming at you with one last time before blasting off for the year. It's been a wild term with everybody on board, as well as with all the members putting up with me. So to end off the year, Anthony style, there's no better way than with this video to look back at everything that's happened so far. So here we go, please enjoy.
Oh. Anyways, it was an important call from my sister. She asked if I wanted 7 leaves. Oh, please load.
Did you tell her the right answer? No.
Of course I said yes.
Did you say no?
What did you ask her for? What are you getting?
I'm getting oolong milk tea.
All right, what are you getting us?
Respectable.
What are you getting us?
It won't load if you answer the question.
I'm getting you this end of the year video.
I'd rather have the long
Top out answer.
Oh.
Hey, everybody, it's your boy, Anthony, and this is the end of the year recap video. To start the video, I just really wanted to say that
the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking.
Wait, is this the time?
Rats, we're the rats. We pray at night, we stalk at night. We're...
Please don't ever dare me to do this again.
Next question.
try to eat it.
Okay, so I...
Still watching?
I got, here a, Crunchwrap Supreme.
But if you will, look right here.
Everyone's a dancer now.
Sharks, where are the sharks? CKI is the reason why the where are the sharks.
Please don't ever dare me to do this again.
Hey, you made it to the end of the video. You made it. But in all seriousness, I just really wanted to say that
you rock.
In the arms of the angel, fly away.
Hold on. Can we switch the language?
Thank you, Anthony. Hey, are you ready, Ricardo?
It's hot in here.
Oh, he's not
gonna. I don't want to.
This is Audrey's turn.
Yeah, this is Audrey's board.
All right, live.
What'd you say? Live? Okay, just.
Yeah, let's do live. Why not? Can you practice it? Go ahead.
Oh, live? No. Okay. Wait, Audrey, are you not speaking or I'll just play the video?
She said live, go.
It starts with Olive.
Hey, so. We wanted to do talent acts and like performances throughout this banquet, but we want to keep this banquet short. So we just had two performances from eBoard. So our eBoard decided to do a skit that we wanted to do last year when we thought banquet was going to be in person. But you know, we still have the same ideas, same concept from last year to this year. So here's our video. I won't full screen since I already have bad quality. Better out than in, I always say. Eh, Fiona? That's good.
I guess not.
What do you mean I'm not on the list? Don't tell me you don't know who I am. Hey, hey, hey! What's up, everybody? Thank you for waiting. You know, I had a hard time finding this place.
No, no, bad donkey, bad down!
Dad, it's alright. It's alright. He's a thot. He helped rescue me from the dragon.
Yep, that's me, the noble steed. Hey, waiter, how about a bowl for the steed?
Oh, boy. Shrek.
Yeah? Oh, sorry. Great soup, Mrs. Q. Mmm.
No, darling.
Oh.
So, Fiona, tell us about where you live.
Well, Shrek owns his own land. Don't you, honey?
Oh, yes. It's an enchanted forest, abundant in squirrels and cute little duckies.
What? I know you ain't talking about donkey. Swamp.
An ogre from a swamp? Oh, how original.
Well, I suppose that would be a fine place to raise the children.
It's a bit early to be thinking about that.
Indeed. I just started eating.
Harold!
What's that supposed to mean?
Dad, it's great, okay?
Well, for his type, yes.
My type?
I've gotta go to the bathroom.
Dinner is served!
Never mind, I can hold it.
Bon appetit!
Oh, Mexican food! My favorite!
Well, let's just not sit here with our tummies rumbling. Everybody dig
in. Don't mind if I do, Lillian.
So, I suppose the grandchildren I could expect from you would
be... Ogres. Yes.
Not that there's anything wrong with that. Right, Harold?
Oh, no, of course not. That is assuming you don't eat your own young.
Dad?
No, we usually prefer the ones who've been locked away in a tower.
Yes, please.
I only did that because I love her.
Daycare or Dragon Garden Castle?
You wouldn't understand. You're not her father.
It's so nice to have the family together for dinner. Harold?
Jack, Fiona?
Fiona?
Harold?
Donkey!
Wow.
You know, that was a lot better than I thought it was.
You didn't watch it? I sent it to you guys before.
No, I refused to watch it beforehand.
You don't like surprises. I mean, you like...
And what an acid trip that was.
I feel like Ricardo, Mariella, and Augie's voices are so accurate.
Yeah, Olivia, your mad voice sounded exactly the same as your any other voice, and it kind of scared me for a little bit. I was like,
"Oh,
why is what's wrong?" It felt like you were wilting.
Okay. On to Ricardo.
I thought you were going to give me a transition, but okay. So now we are coming to a close. Hi, everyone. If you don't know me, I am Ricardo Porras, and I am no longer serving as your vice president of administration for the 2020 to 2021 term. So now you're going to be hearing speeches from both me and Olivia. For me, I really don't know what to say exactly. I've never been one to write out speeches before. And if my last speeches were any indicator, I tend to add humor when I don't want to get emotional, but I'm going to try to get through all this without cracking a joke. So let's see how long that lasts. Here we are at the last event for the term, culminating in 2 years straight for me being on board. I don't really have much to say in terms of my Circle K experience, because overall, I feel like I've been pretty vocal to everyone on this club about what it's like for me being on board or being a member here. But I did make some of my closest friends from this club, and I've gotten to meet so many people both in and out of Long Beach Circle K, and all of those memories just culminating together has really been an experience for me. However, I do think some of the biggest memories I have made here have been when I was fellowship chair and a fam head, seeing everybody having fun, enjoying life together, and basically breaking the ice, bonding, stuff like that. And right now, this term, seeing everyone on my board grow so much as a VPA. I would just like to thank all the members of the appointed board for everything they've done, all the work they put into this term. It's not easy being on an online term, and all 11 of them pulled through the entire time and just made it spectacular. I couldn't have asked for a better board. No amount of time and words could really be used to explain just how grateful I am for every individual on this board. I have already given them individual praises plenty of times before in our own private meetings and other get-togethers. So before all this ends, I would just like to say for Millennia, AJ, Anthony, Allen, Jonathan, Guy, Kyla, McKenna, Coy, Hannah, and Renz, all I have left to say to you guys that I haven't said before is that I'm proud of each and every one of you, and that it was an honor to serve as your vice president of administration. Each of you brought a new and refreshing energy and such dedication to the club that I believe makes you one of the most standout appointed boards in not just our club's history, but in all of CNH's. Although not everyone in the club may know who some of you are, the work all of you put in was definitely shown throughout the term, whether it's been through all the funds we've raised, standout graphics, hilarious videos, our new blossoming relations with the Kiwanis family, the spectacular family and recognition systems that shape our members' experiences, our incredible social media presence, expanding what it means to do service with impact teams, all of our events, both large and small, our award-winning FTC skit, which is also the first time we've got in, and the best website in CNH this term. This all seems like I'm flexing, because it is. Everyone on this board deserves to be flexed for all their glory and all the work they put in. But what is an A board without their E board? Starting with Lillian and Mariella, I've gotten to know them throughout the years when they first joined as freshmen. And I'm just so happy to see where they are now, from shy and quiet freshmen to these hardworking individuals who have gone the very best to do all of they can for this club. I know they're absolutely going to kill whatever career path they want to do and whatever decisions they make in life. I fully support everything they do. For my co, Miss Audrey Halim, I don't know if she's there, but I feel like she turned off her camera. She may be the butt of everyone's joke in this club, but there is truly no other person in this position that I would have wanted to share the title of vice president with. And she genuinely embodies the baby sister I have never had, but have always wanted. And finally, for Olivia, I don't really know what to say, because I doubt you're gonna cry at whatever I'm gonna say. So with just this, I think I speak for everyone in this entire call, in this entire organization, that have known you for like the past 5 years. You are the pinnacle of what a CKI officer should be. You are the gold standard of what every student, CKI member, club officer, person, any other noun to describe a living being should be. And you really deserve all the credit that everyone's been giving you, all the awards you've won here and in previous terms. If you notice, most of my speech is about praising the board and not about CKI being a family or a home away from home. Because usually you would reserve all that for saying goodbye to all of that. I don't really plan on saying goodbye anytime soon after this term ends. Just because it ends of me being a club officer doesn't mean I'm gonna stop checking in on my successor or what the new board is gonna do or catching up with my previous two boards. So this is not a goodbye for me from Circle K. This is just saying farewell to everyone on my board. I don't know what else to say. This has been one of the most memorable experiences of my life. Just one final thing is for my successor, Lenore. I don't know if she's here because she's been popping in and out of the call, but I know you and your board will do an excellent job. And I can already tell now, with this being only a few weeks into your term, that you will surpass both me and all of the previous vice presidents of administrations from Circle K, and you will be the best of all of us. I would now like to yield the rest of my time for caucus, pass it on to Olivia. That's you, Olivia.
Wow, thank you, Ricardo. I hate you. So I started my speech like less than an hour ago. Ricardo said, it's fine if you take 3 minutes because I'll just go into yours because I have a lot to say. But he ended early. So thank you for that too, Ricardo. Anyways, wow. Like I said, I was cramming everything for banquet and I have a project due at midnight, but that doesn't give me an excuse, I guess. So here's my speech. Hi, hello everyone. First, I wanted to thank everyone for coming out again to our board's final event. It's been pretty unreal and still hasn't really sunk in that I'm now officially done with Circle K and soon college, which is why I feel like I never cry until maybe after. But wow, I've been in the Kiwanis family ever since freshman year in high school with Kiwins, and I definitely never would have thought I'd stay all the way till my final year in college. So I wanted to say thank you, Circle K. Thank you to all the people I've met along my journey. Each and every person I've met, whether it was through the service events or another general member in the club, helped to inspire me, teach me, and break me out of my comfort zone. I went from that quiet and shy member in my freshman year in CSULB Circle K to becoming one of the loudest members in our club, and maybe even the district, but let's not mention that. To my board members, I know that I tend to like not show my emotions a lot and tend to not really express my appreciation often. Audrey even called me an Asian parent who responds with K instead of I'm proud of you and I love you. But yeah, I'm really grateful for each and every one of you. And I definitely got lucky that I've been able to work with amazing leaders in every team I've been a part of. There were so many things we were looking forward to do in person, so many events we didn't get to do, traditions we didn't get to pass on, unplanned setbacks, etc. I remember like just a few months ago messaging Ricardo and telling him how nervous I felt that everything was coming to an end, and I feel like there is still so much that we didn't do. But it was all bittersweet. Despite everything, we really stuck it through and we made it. While I'm definitely sad we weren't able to have in-person hangouts and retreats with one another, I definitely think we made the most of what we had. Seeing all our accomplishments and seeing it be recognized throughout was so amazing to me. It's still pretty surreal how we were able to get first place club improvement when we felt like we didn't improve this past year, just judging from the numbers. I still believe we improved in other aspects of the club. We were able to try out new opportunities with the family system, become more involved with our alumni and Kiwanians, break our goal for interclubs not once, but twice, create new innovative ideas never done before, and finally build the foundation for future boards and so much more. To the general members, I can't tell you guys enough how much y'all were the reason we were so dedicated and passionate about what we do. The new members who just joined this past year, you guys are freaking amazing and dedicated, and y'all really decided to join this club during a pandemic. I hope you guys enjoyed your first experience with Circle K and that it'll only keep getting better and better. There's so much more to see with you guys taking on new opportunities, and I can't wait to watch you guys grow and become our future leaders. To probably the oldest members in this club, the ones who've been there since our freshman year at CSULB, Kathleen, Jonathan, Anthony, and even Kari, it's definitely been reassuring to know that I still have some day ones with me in the club. As the friends we made through this organization graduate, it's hard to keep the same passion, especially when you realize that we're no longer the little freshmen of the club. We're done. We did it. And I'm happy to know that y'all are always supporting me in the sidelines. So to Circle K, thank you for everything. I've learned to really appreciate and cherish every moment, because you never know when it might be your last. And finally, to Audrey and the new board, I know that you guys have big plans, and I will definitely be here to support y'all whenever you need. But I am not going to be the first alumni webinar. And while it has been looking better, this year is definitely just as obscure as the last. But I know that Audrey will make sure y'all will have a memorable and special furry year. So yeah, it's been a crazy year, but we're done. And I think we couldn't have done any better. I'm extremely honored to have been able to serve as your president for this past term. And thank you guys for believing in me and creating an impact on my life. Yes, thank you. I now pass it on to Matthew Uyamov to retire us. Just a fun fact, we never got installed.
Were we ever on board? Think about it.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Perfect. Well, hello once again, CSULB. As your immediate past Metro LTG, I have had the honor and privilege to work with this amazing board. They accomplished a lot with everything they were handed, especially during a panini. And I am so proud to have the honor of officially retiring them today. As I read each name, make sure to congratulate each and every single one of them in the chat. Starting with the 2020 to 2021 appointed board. With our technology chair, Renz Lane. Spirit and social chair, Hannah Macaranas. Special events chair, Min Koi Trin. Service projects chair, McKenna Pollen. Public relations chair, Kyla Anderson. Membership development and recognition chair, Guy Songkao. Membership Development and Education Chair, Jonathan Achino. Kiwanis Family Chair, Alan Vu. Oh, I'll let it catch up.
I didn't know there was pictures.
I'm at Alan now. All right, Historian, Anthony Fan. Graphics chair, AJ Escano. And fundraising, Lenia Lin. And to the 2020 to 2021 elected board, starting with the treasurer, Mariella Mitchell. Secretary, Lillian An. Vice president of service, Audrey Halim. Vice president of administration, Ricardo Porras.
It's a nice picture.
Your president, Olivia Chang.
Click it again, Olivia.
Thank you. Thank you for all of your dedication and service. And congratulations, you're all hereby retired.
Wow, 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 wow.
And with that, now please welcome Matthew Kim, your new Metro Lieutenant Governor, to install the new board.
Hello, everyone. My name is Matthew Kim, and I currently serve as your Lieutenant Governor for the 2021-2022 term. With every new term comes a new set of potential inspiration, and ways that a club can grow and develop themselves throughout this next term. All these qualities are exactly what the 2021-2022 board for CSULB embodies. I can't wait to see all the projects, new ideas, and things they will accomplish throughout their term. And with that being said, I would now like to install the 2021-2022 board, starting with the appointed board. With technology, we have Matthew Ujimov. With spirit and social, we have Adora May Bosano. For service projects, we have Kristen Von Wagner. For recognition and programs, we have Norma Chu. For public relations, we have Nicole K. Augustine. For Kiwanis family, we have Nathan Cortez. For historian, we have Kyla Anderson. For graphics, we have Stephanie Hong. For fundraising, we have Yazid Makun. For development and education, we have Alex Caseros. For the 2021-2022 executive board, for treasurer, we have Kobe Wu. For secretary, we have Michaela Pollan. For vice president of service, we have Diane Nguyen. For vice president of administration, we have Lenore Fabi. And for president, we have Audrey Halim. I cannot wait to work with every single one of you throughout this next upcoming term, and let's have a great one all together. And with that, I would like to now officially install the CSULB Circle K board for the 2021-2022 term.
Wow, 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 wow.
And with that, I would like to pass it on to Olivia for the 2021-2022 eBoard performance.
Oh. Wow, wow, wow. Thank you, Matt Ujimov and Matt Kim, for retiring and installing us. And congratulations to the 2020-2021 board for officially retiring once again, and to 2021-2022 board for officially getting inducted. Whoa. We now have a very special performance from the new eBoard members.
Girl, I'm waiting on you. I'm waiting on you. Come on and let me sneak you out. And have a celebration. Celebration. The windows up, the windows down.
Yeah, what we do and what we do, just pretending that we're cool and we know it too. Yeah, we keep doing what we do, just pretending that we're cool, so the night.
Let's go crazy, crazy, crazy till we see the sun. I know we won't ever, let's pretend it's love. And never, never, never stop for anything.
We all CKI,
We're about to make some memories tonight.
Let's go crazy, 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 till we see the sun.
What'd you say at the end? That scared me.
And live while we're young.
Gosh, Olivia, could you not use context clues?
Und lebst, während wir jung sind.
I could totally tell. Wow.
So when's the live performance?
Let's.
Oh, wow, 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 wow,
oh. Wow. Thank you guys for that. What a nice transition into the incoming president's speech.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Yes. Yes. All right. Now, this is the story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I could take a minute, just sit right there, and I'll tell you how I became the president of a college called Legoshiville. Don't worry. I'm just playing about Legoshi. When I was a freshman, I never thought I'd join this club. I thought I'd join some random fraternity or involve myself in ASI. I was also incredibly serious, and I tried to impress others with a gimmick identity that I heavily regret. But for some reason, I showed up to PTP Dolls, where I was met by a cast of funny, chaotic, humble, and friendly people, some of which became my own best friends later on in life, like Stinky Alan Vu. I love this club so much that I dragged my Minecraft boyfriend, Matthew Maldo Binky, into the club. And it was these same people that helped me feel confident and comfortable just to be myself. And you're all the reason why I'm my loud, stinky, big baby Dora self today. I broke down my walls and I stopped caring about impressing others, but rather truly about connecting with others. Then I came to Help Me Help You and FTC, and I would start a daily ritual of heading into the library basement for the strangers that became my friends. Despite the consistent roasts and playful bullying, I ended up loving this club and called it home. The kind encouragement and emphasis on building each other up as leaders inspired me to seek out VPS at the end of my first year. Despite an online term, it almost felt the same. Loads of jokes, deep talks, inviting everyone to be closer to one another, etc. And so being VPS taught me that our club was full of kind-hearted people that cared about others and about me. I'm still a little stinky and very, very loud, but I hope that I and our new board are still able to bring the same chaotic, inclusive atmosphere that led me to love this club and call it home as a freshman, because CKI will always be a family. Let's transition to Kyla.
You could adjourn this first.
All right. I will adjourn this meeting at 8:50 p.m.
Banquet
at 8:50 p.m.
Where's the ding?
Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, that was loud. Wow, thank you.
Let's go.
All right, so.